Welcome to the service. I hope you're doing well, and I hope we can, sooner than later, gather together again under the roof of our church. Welcome. Let us begin with thanksgiving for baptism. Joined to Christ with waters of baptism, we are raised with him to new life. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you created us in your image and planted us in a well-watered garden. In the desert, you promised pools of water for the parched, and you gave us water from the rock. When we did not know the way, you sent the Good Shepherd to lead us to still waters. At the cross, you watered us from Jesus' wounded side. And on this day, you shower us again with the water of life. We praise you for your salvation through water and for all water everywhere. Bathe us in your forgiveness, grace, and love. Satisfy the thirsty and give us the life only you can give. To your given honor and praise, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world. Sweet the rains new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where God's feet pass. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden's a play. Praiseless elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new day.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
On high, Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad. glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, you hold together all things in heaven and earth. In your great mercy, receive the prayers of your children and give to all the world the spirit of your truth and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now I invite all you children and soul-minded. I guess you can't really get close to here, but hey, I hope you're close there. So, when I was quite young, I think I was 2 years old when I got so-called my first dog. Holly was his name. We used to spend hours playing together while he was fetching sticks and a ball, and he sat down and laid down when I asked. He was one smart puppy. I loved Holly. And guess how I showed Holly that I loved him? I took care of him. I made sure that he got exercise and had a place to sleep. I made sure that he had plenty of food and water. One of the most important ways I showed my love was by spending time with him. You see, love is not something you say, it is something you show by the things we do. It is the way we act toward someone or something. So what do you say, or what do you think? How does Jesus know that you love him? That's not an easy question, is it? I think it's a pretty hard one. In today's gospel text, Jesus gives the answer to that question himself. Jesus said, "Those who accept my commandments and obey them are the ones who love me. And because they love me, my Father will love them, and I will love them." What are some things we can do to show our love for Jesus? Well, I think the Bible is a good place to find the answer. Here are a few ways that I found, and I can imagine you might think of some more. In John chapter 13, Jesus says, "Love one another." Luke 4 tells us, "Worship him. Tell others about Jesus" in Acts. "Talk to him daily in prayer" in Matthew. "And read his word, says Psalm 119. "Forgive others as you forgive. Forgive others as you forgive us." Matthew 6:15. Let's all pray together. Dear God, we are quick to tell you that we love you, and yet we know that we need to show our love too. Help us to show our love for you just as you show your love to us. And thanks for Jesus. Amen.
Today's reading comes from Acts chapter 17, verses 22 to 31. Then Paul stood in front of Areopagus and said, "Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found them among I found among them an altar with the inscription, "To an unknown God." What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you: the God who made the world and everything in it, he who is Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands as though he needed anything, since he himself gives to all mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor he made all nations to inhabit the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of the places where they would live, so they would search for God and perhaps grope for him and find him. Though indeed he is not far from each one of us, for in him we live and move and have our being, as even some of your own poets have said, "From one we too are his offspring, for we too are his offspring." Since we are God's offspring, we ought not think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by the man he has appointed. And of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. The word of the Lord.
Reading is from Peter chapter 3, verse 13 to 22. Who is going to harm you if you are eager to do good? But even if you should suffer for what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear what they fear. Do not be frightened. But in your hearts, set apart Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you to give the reason for the hope that you have, but do this with gentleness and respect, keeping a clear conscience, so that those who speak maliciously against your good behavior in Christ may be ashamed of their slander. It is better if it is God's will to suffer for doing good than for doing evil. For Christ died for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God. He was put to death in the body, but made alive by the Spirit, through whom also he went and preached to the spirits in prison, who disobeyed long ago when God waited patiently in the days of Noah, while the ark was being built. In it only a few people, eight in all were saved through water, and this water symbolizes baptism that now saves you also. Not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pledge. A good conscience toward God, it saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at God's right hand, with angels, authorities, and powers in submission to him. Amen.
The Holy Gospel according to John, chapter 14. Jesus said to the disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I'm coming to you. In a little while the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live, you live also. On that day you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me, and those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace to you and peace in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It's a real joy for me to be able to be with you in this way on this day during this time of pandemic. Our national office is closed, and I have been working from home. It's easy to feel isolated and dislocated from the church that I am called to serve. And yet, I've joined in three different synod council meetings by Zoom, and I've joined congregations from each one of the synods in worship on Sundays. The synod bishops and I are meeting more frequently than ever, and so are the synodical and national treasurers. In many ways, I feel more connected to the church at this time than I usually do. And it may last for a lot longer than any of us had hoped for. But there is also no doubt that we are still a church called to follow the way of Jesus and participate in God's mission to love and save the world. In today's gospel lesson, Jesus reminds us that if we love him, we need to keep his commandments, to love God with all our heart and soul and strength and mind, and to love our neighbors as ourselves. If you are like me, then you probably have days when it seems pretty easy to follow this directive, and then there are days that it seems a lot harder. In this time of pandemic, it's easy for me to have days when I get so anxious and worried that all I can think about is myself. But there are other days, and thank God more of them, where I am far more concerned with those who are working on the front lines, for those who are mourning people who have died from COVID-19, for refugees living in camps with poor sanitary conditions, for homeless people in Canada and around the world, for those living on reserves with boil water advisories, and so on and so on. And although I'm not able to do very much hands-on to make a difference, I increase my prayers and I increase my donations. The wonderful thing is that Jesus does not just ask us to follow his commandments and then abandon us. Jesus promises to not leave us orphaned. In our gospel lesson today, Jesus promises to send us an advocate, to help and guide us in the ways of truth, This is, of course, the coming of the Holy Spirit that we will celebrate in 2 weeks' time on Pentecost Sunday. Although today's gospel lesson comes before Jesus' crucifixion and death, it is very similar to the messages of assurance that Jesus gives us in his post-resurrection appearances. God is with us. Jesus is with us. The Spirit is with us. We are not alone. As Paul reminds us in the reading from Acts, in God we live and move and have our being. In my lifetime, I have never experienced such a time as this. Prolonged isolation, churches closed, the loss of many leisure activities, my work life totally restructured. For those who are working on the front line, there is the real and present danger of becoming sick or dying. For many people, there have been the loss of jobs. For many others, there are great financial worries. We can keep in touch with each other, with loved ones, by telephone or by a number of social media means, but it's not the same as being together. It's definitely not the same as being able to give and to receive a hug. There are two kinds of natural responses we can experience in such disorienting times. The first is to feel the absence of God, to ask where God is, to blame God for the pandemic, to ask why our prayers are not being answered. Or is it there is the opposite response, to feel more closely the presence of God? If you are in the former camp, I totally understand it, but please know that God has not abandoned you. God is with you. However, I'm finding I'm firmly in the latter camp. I'm finding with fewer options of things to do and with a much more regular daily rhythm to my life, that it's easier to have a regular and increased prayer and devotional life. I've been choosing a hymn each day and writing a prayer to go along with the hymn and encouraging to join me in both the singing and the praying. I sing the hymn most days and post it to social media. But while I'm singing and praying, I am so aware of God's presence with me. When I go out for my daily walk, I have been so aware of God's presence in wind and snow and flooding and the slow, slow greeting of a late prairie spring. I am so aware of God's presence with me when I get an unexpected call from a friend who is checking in on me. And in the smiles of grocery checkout clerks, and in the kindness of people politely taking turns and keeping appropriate physical distancing, whether it's in the grocery store or in the park. My favorite prayer is, O God, you have called your servants to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths as yet untrodden, through perils unknown. Give us faith to go out with good courage, not knowing where we go, but only that your hand is leading us and your love supporting us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. These are challenging times, and there are unknown endings, but God is with us. Take courage in God's presence in your life and rest securely in God's love. We will be changed by this experience, but we will still be a church willing to serve God. God bless you today and every day. Amen.
I come with joy, a child of God, forgiven, loved, and free. The life of Jesus to recall, in love lay down for me, in love lay down for me. I come with Christians far and near, to find us all are fed, the new community of love, in Christ communion bread, in Christ communion bread. As Christ breaks bread and bids us share, each proud division ends. The love that made us makes us one, and strangers now are friends, and strangers now are friends. The Spirit of the risen Christ, unseen but ever near, is in such friendships better known, alive among us here, alive among us here. Together met, together bound by all that God has done, we'll go with joy to give the world the love that makes us one, the love that makes us one.
With the whole church, let us confess our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Turning our hearts to God, who is gracious and merciful, we pray for the Church, the world, and all who are in need. As God's beloved children, let us pray that the light of Christ shine on the nations, the church, and all those in need, saying, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, our healer, show your compassion for the whole human family that is in turmoil and burdened with illness and fear. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Come to our aid as the coronavirus spreads globally. Heal those who are sick, support and protect their families and friends from being infected. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant us your spirit of love and self-discipline so that we may come together working to control and eliminate the coronavirus. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Make us vigilant, attentive, and proactive in the eradication of all diseases, malaria, dengue, HIV and AIDS, and others that creating suffering and often result in death for many people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heal our self-centeredness and indifference that makes us worry only when the virus threatens us. Open ways beyond timidity and fear that too easily ignore our neighbor. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Strengthen and encourage those in public health services and in the medical profession, caregivers, nurses, attendants, doctors, all who commit themselves to caring for the sick and their families. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Inspire, give insight, and hope to all researchers focused on developing a vaccine. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Sustain all workers and business owners who suffer loss of livelihood due to shutdowns, quarantines, closed borders, and other restrictions. Protect and guard all those who must travel. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide the leaders of the nations that they speak the truth. Halt the spread of misinformation and act with justice so that all your family may know healing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heal our world, heal our bodies, strengthen our hearts and our minds, and in the midst of turmoil, give us hope and peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray especially for those whom we may name in our hearts or aloud. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hold in your gentle embrace all who have died and who will die this day. Comfort their loved ones in their despair. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Remember all your family, the entire human race, and all your creation in your love. Receive our prayers and hopes. God of grace and mercy, we entrust all for whom we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, light of the nations, salvation of the world, Lord of us all. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always. Let us pray as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May God, who has brought us from death to life, fill you with great joy. Almighty God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
On our way rejoicing, gladly let us go. Christ our Lord has conquered, vanquished is the foe. Christ without our safety, Christ within our joy. Who, if we be faithful, can our hope destroy? On our way rejoicing, as we forward move, hearken to our praises, O blessed God of love. Unto God the Father, joyful songs we sing. Unto God the Savior, thankful hearts we bring. Unto God the Spirit, bow we and adore. On our way rejoicing, now and evermore. On our way rejoicing, as we forward move, hearken to our praises, O blessed God of love.
Hallelujah. Go in peace. Share the good news. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. And please remember to be in touch with each other, your family, your friends, in the best way that seems right for you. See you again. Bye-bye.